you could soon find out whether our own National Security Agency has spied on you. That's according to the investigative journalist Glenn Greenwald, who claims he has that information. Former NSA contractor Edward Snowden last year leaked secret documents that revealed a vast U.S. government system for monitoring phone and internet data. Greenwald says Snowden gave him a slew of those documents last year in Hong Kong. Now Glenn Greenwald says he'll make his biggest revelation ever later this week, releasing the names of U.S. citizens that the NSA has targeted in its data collection program. Greenwald says he's saving the best for last, like the grand finale of a fireworks show. Fox News senior judicial analyst Judge Andrew Napolitano is here. Read the book over the weekend, my understanding.
The book is called No Place to Hide.
Right.
And it is a description of the frenetic two-week period in the lives of Glenn Greenwald and Edward Snowden when they, with others, were working in a hotel room in Hong Kong, and Snowden was giving Greenwald the documents that he took from NSA. Shep, on a couple of those little keys that you put in the computer, 1.7 million documents. So it took a long time for Snowden to explain them to Greenwald. Snowden wasn't initially disbelieved by Greenwald. Greenwald and his colleagues were skeptical, not after listening to him, not after grilling him, not after looking at the government's own documents.
Now, what we're supposed to learn this week from Greenwald is who was targeted by the NSA.
Okay, Greenwald has all of those documents, and these revelations that we've been getting every two or three weeks, they've slowed down a little bit of late, have been coming from Greenwald, not from Snowden. Mm-hmm. According to Greenwald, Snowden does not have these documents with him any longer in Russia, mm-hmm. because he was worried that some foreign agents would take them from him. Greenwald has the documents, and Greenwald has been releasing them, and Greenwald said yesterday, before this week is out, I'll release the grand finale, which will surprise everyone when they see whose names are on the list, what American names are on the list that the NSA has been targeting. What has the NSA's model been? We're looking for a needle in a haystack. We want the entire haystack. So while they have targeted people, their motto has been, you ready for this? Collect it all. And if you look at Greenwald's book, which has copies of the documents in there, you'll see on the tops of those documents the NSA motto, collect it all. They want everything about everybody, and they want it available for them, stored in their computers permanently.
It is somewhat astounding that our privacy has been violated in this way, and that a government would be able to collect this private information doesn't look very American.
Oh, good gosh, it's not American at all. It profoundly violates the oath that President George W. Bush, President Obama, and all the people in the NSA that worked for both of them undertook. I could understand a government saying the only way we could keep you safe is we know everything about you, but not a government governed by our Constitution and not by people who took the same oath to uphold the Constitution that anybody, including me, who's ever worked for the government has taken, because that Constitution is superior to everything else, and those people who took that oath know it, and they're knowingly violating it.
If they've broken their oath, what should happen to them?
Well, the courts would say vote him out of office, but President Bush served two terms. President Obama is halfway through his second term, so that's not a realistic remedy. Look, the Constitution is only as good a restraint on the government as those in whose hands the Constitution is given for enforcement and for honoring and for respecting. It is not in good hands when the people in whose hands it has been placed can rampantly trample and violate it, as the NSA has been doing.